The youths earlier peacefully protested the ongoing events in the nation's judiciary, which led to the suspension of the president of the nation's Court of Appeal, Ayo Salami.
Enough is enough! Lock out the judiciary!
They were stopped at the entrance to the National Assembly by heavily armed policemen who barred them from entering the complex. The police, however, collected their letter for onward delivery to the Senate president. After the protest, some members were seen being carried away by security personnel, though the police still denied arresting them.
We have not made any arrest, and nobody has been taken anywhere. Okay, but if we are going to make arrest, it is nothing to run shy away from. I will tell you we've made arrest.
One of the leaders of the group condemned this action, saying it is an affront on democracy and abuse to the rule of law.
We are not surprised that the police are going out of their boundary. You know, it's leadership by example. Because if you look at it, the question you need to ask is, even the president, Jonathan himself, is a product of collective struggle of Nigerians. People went to the street to agitate for him when there was a constitutional gap, you know, without a letter being transmitted to him to take over as commander-in-chief. It is this same crowd that we use in enforcing that he must be sworn in as commander-in-chief, first as an acting president, then secondly as commander-in-chief. On this issue, the police under him, we don't expect them to be so hostile the way they are, especially one ACP we seen in Alegu. I mean, it's deliberate, as I mentioned. The guy is too offset all effort that we have to submit a letter to the national. They prevented us. They were saying that our something is causing panic, our this is this, our. At the end of the day, we ended up submitting the letter to him. Probably we pray that we hand it over to Mr. President or hand it over to the Senate President.
Leaders of the youth groups have confirmed that one of their leaders, Tijani Usman, and 8 others are in police custody. They say they will challenge this arrest in the court of law. Amadin Uyi, NN24. Abuja.